Hello all, welcome to Black Girl in the World. If you don't know me, you will, and if you do, welcome back. Happy March and happy Women's History Month. Oh my God, I love that each month has a different thing we need to be aware of. Shout out to all the women around me, especially Black women whose voices were only heard through their inventions until now, where we have platforms like these to demonstrate our free and open-minded selves. I just love it all and hope you guys do too. Here I have a special guest that I have patiently waited for to join me on this here platform. I met her when I was a freshie in college. An amazing person, being able to have her own business and makeup is truly a skill I've admired about her. She has allowed me to express myself and have also taught me vulnerability. She's grown to be a beautiful, funny, and all-around relatable sister. My friend C, how are you today? Is the weather treating you well?
Hi, you guys. The weather has been in and out. The weather has been crazy. It's been snowing every week since the freaking year started. I'm over it.
I know, but we did have them 2 days that were...
Them only 2 days.
Yeah. So, what are we talking about today, C?
We're talking about our qualifications that we're looking for in men. We're talking about what we want for ourselves, what inspires us to be strong.
Yes, I love that. So what do we want, C, and when do we want it?
Everything. I need it now.
I felt it. So we actually created our list last year because it was just at a point in our lives where we were just like, hey, this is something that we definitely want to write down. In a way, it has helped me a lot to figure out who I want in my circle, not just in a guy to get with, but friendships too, right?
Definitely. In everything. We can talk all day about guys and men and how men make us feel in the worst way possible, but you have to find those relationships within your friends, within your family, anybody.
Yeah, wholeheartedly. I completely agree with you. Do you want to start with your first thing on your list?
Yes. I'm a juggle through here. I'm joking. Y'all, I have a long list, okay? Like, I have a long one. Look at that. So, my first one is compassionate.
Okay. I like that. I love compassionate. Now, what do you mean by that?
Sensitive. Not weak, but vulnerable enough to understand my vulnerability.
Yeah, I respect that. I completely agree because I feel like men, the ones that I know, can have such a huge wall around them that makes them feel like I shouldn't be sad. I can't cry in front of my girlfriend.
It's no big deal.
Right, it's not that serious. Why are you crying? Why are you, you know, you don't have to be like that. You can definitely understand and respect someone even if you don't fully understand what they're going through or why it's such a big deal to them, you know? So that's, I feel like, true. Yeah.
That's true. Yeah, I don't like the thought that I have to teach somebody my ways and to get them to open up sometimes. I don't mind, but sometimes it's like, being compassionate, honestly, it's not a common thing as much as I thought it was. I really thought it was really common to be compassionate as humans. Nah, it wasn't. It really wasn't.
It's not at all. It takes some skill, apparently.
The whole skill.
It takes a huge skill, but I'm glad that you had it on there because, you know, we don't really realize there are a lot of us who didn't know that it's a skill that you have to be compassionate. People get taught empathy, that we thought that that should be included as a human being, but no. One thing that I have on my list is rationalizing, because you know I love rational people. Please be able to rationalize your thoughts and feelings. Even when we argue, we might feel the urge to say things we can't take back because we can be so upset. But please don't make that mistake with me. That's what I wrote.
Wow. That's a really good trait, because, oh my gosh, that's so good. How come I didn't think of that?
No, it's okay. Honestly, compassionate can be included in that. Like, that could be umbrella, but yeah.
Rational thinking is something that everybody should have. I mean, you have moments you do lash out, but like you said, you can't take back the words you say. And you got to be quick on your feet when it comes to the positive sides of things. You cannot be quick to be throwing tantrums and being negative all the time. I'm learning that for myself. So that was perfect.
I agree wholeheartedly, because it's like I've experienced, whether it was me or somebody else, who said things that they really couldn't take back. And it's like those things haunt you. And we've all had those embarrassing experiences of doing something in high school, middle school, or even, you know, elementary school, where you're like, dang, I'm so embarrassed that that happened to me. So can you just imagine that with a good friend of yours or a really good relationship that you basically screwed up because you said something that shouldn't have came out of your mouth?
I felt that. Wow. The second one I have is similar to the first one, so I'm going to skip it. It said no one to be vulnerable. Okay. Well, no, I don't want to skip it. I'll talk about it. I have a habit of... No, I take that back. Back then, I used to have a habit of... right message, wrong time. And it just ruined so much for me. I was constantly like, it was just the wrong timing. And I just never knew when it was the right time. But that's because those people that I was being vulnerable with, they just didn't understand it. So maybe it really was the right time, but they don't know how to be vulnerable. So they put it back on you to think that, can we do this later? When is later? Because they're not ready to face the vulnerability that you're about to bring out of them. That's just honest truth.
It's true. And it's like, sometimes you can't put those situations on a back burner because we have so many things to do.
Mm-hmm. Got more things to think about.
Yes. And more problems created. So it's like, you have the same thing that you've been cooking up for years now. And then there's new pots, new recipe, new ingredients you have to make.
Not relevant no more after the fact. So you want to talk about what we should have spoke about years ago in 2021. No, I'm done with that. You didn't want to do it then. I'm not going to do it now. You're late to the party, as I want to say.
Yes, you're late to the party. You didn't even get an invitation at all. So what's so funny is that the second one that I have is also similar to the rationalizing thing that I mentioned earlier, but it goes a little bit deeper. It's just identifying the rights and wrongs of things. And so the example that I created was, you know, deciding to choose to remove the art away from the artist. Like, I'm not fully mad at people who still listen to certain people that people stopped listening to a long time ago due to them being abusive, but what do you have to say?
I just want to add on that cancel culture has really played a part, the temporary cutoff, you know. Trigger warning, you guys. Robert Kelly is crazy. And people still listen to him. You got some people that just won't stop. And if you watch Boondocks, then that whole episode is point blank to the point, exactly what we're talking about.
Exactly.
You don't want to cancel them because they have good music, but you do have to identify what's right and wrong. And even if it's wrong, they don't really want to be right. Some people get adrenaline off of doing things that are wrong. A lot of men that I've known are those type of guys. They just don't care how wrong they are. They're going to keep doing it because they just feel so good. Behind closed doors is a whole different ballgame. And unfortunately, we got to deal with it. We got to deal with it. And pointing the wrongs in yourself is always going to be, I don't want to say top tier, but you feel lifted. That's what I should have said.
I agree completely, because it's like, sometimes people can listen to the artist so much that they say that they can do no wrong in my eyes. And it's like, no, they're human beings as well. They've said things, they've done some things that we don't fully agree with. Some people stop listening to them because of that, which I can respect. But please know that that's something that they did. If you're going to continue listening to them, own up to it. You know, there are going to be people that you get cut off from. There are going to be people that won't talk to you anymore because of that. But if you want to keep on doing it, know that that's what they did and that's wrong. And I feel like a lot of guys that I've spoken with have always used these really weird Hotep questions about that, like, especially in the shade room. That's why I don't look in their comment section, because sometimes they be like, with the whole trigger warning, but with the whole Tory Lanez and Meg thing, they like, you know, kind of the questions in the comment section really threw me off. And it was just one of those things where it's like, okay, so why can Meg talk about it, but he can't, kind of questions. And it's like, if you're listening to him, just say that. If you're still listening to him, just say it. Don't be asking questions like that.
And you know what's crazy? You know what? Nope. Next. Go ahead.
It's okay. I'm sorry for bringing that up, because no, the conversation is ongoing, and honestly, I have no words anymore for him. You know, I honestly just,
the situation alone, I had nothing else to say. Today was that day when I found out that he wasn't able to talk about it. Still, I was like, goodbye, I'm out.
Yeah, I was just like, all right, well, it's honestly in the court's hands at this point. I hope that Meg does receive justice from it, because it's just an ongoing case at this point. How is we, FBI Twitter, to really sort out and figure out when there's attorneys there and there's investigators? We are not the investigators. And I honestly believe that he did it. That's what I think. I will say that on my podcast. I believe that he did it, and I want justice to be served.
Period.
That is it. That is all. So sorry for the rant, but that's what I mean. Identifying the rights and wrongs. At the end of the day, not all of our faves are the best people in the world. They have said a few things, whether it's in the past, they've changed now, or they're continuing to say it, and they just pretend like they don't. We just have to understand that that is something people do, and if you're going to continue listening to them, hey, but just know that that's really, honestly. So what is another thing on your list, C?
You guys, The biggest one on this part right now is listening, regardless of your opinions or thoughts on the situation. I need and want a man that listens to me, and not give their input on every little thing to make it seem like I'm the problem. What I'm trying to say is I don't want someone to pick sides often. I need someone that's like, I can be like, baby, and they'd be like, oh no, they shouldn't have done that. Or I'm not saying to tell me what I want to hear. That's not the situation. It's more so like, if I'm coming home from work and I had a long day, I just need you to listen. I don't want no inputs. I don't want no, you was wrong. Just let me vent. Most importantly, I feel like listening goes along with the actions that lead to the happy parts of your relationship. You know what I'm saying? That goes for anybody. I feel like I could have told you something important about me as far as what I look for in a man, and you probably wasn't even listening to number one to number three as we're speaking. It's not fair. I don't need that.
I agree. Sometimes you're just like, babe, just shut up. Please be quiet. Let me, you know. And I think a good thing to incorporate, which is what you mean, is that let me know that my feelings are valid about it. It's not about whether I was right or whether I was wrong, but you've felt my experience. You've heard a lot of things that I've been going through. This thing triggered me. And it might not be something that triggers you, but you know that that's where I'm at in my life. So my feelings are valid. And sometimes we need that reassurance to say, okay, well, I see where you're coming from. And if you're in the space, see that you're open to him saying, however, whatever, whatever. And you're just like, maybe you're right. And then you smile and go about your day. Like, that's okay.
What does sucks is when, so let's say it was the opposite way around, where I'm like, okay, you got it. Just to not even continue the conversation because you were already picking on me about how wrong I was when that's not what I asked for. So now I have to be like, babe, I'm about to vent. I just need you to listen. I don't want no inputs after. And it's just like, why do we have to indicate that? Like, I feel like some conversations you'll just know that I'm venting. And sometimes when you're venting, you just say things that you don't mean. And you cannot give me that random response. Well, you would have been mad if this happened. And I would have been like, okay, I didn't ask though. Although, yes, that is true. I did not ask for that input in that moment. You could have told me this later when things are calmed down. That's all I say. I'm done with that.
Exactly. Exactly. Let me tell you, it's true. Like, and I guess like sometimes we're not used to saying what we need them to hear or what we need anybody to hear. Like, hey, I just want you to close your mouth and open your ears. That's all I need. And that's it. You just sit there, watch TV. If you feel like you're not really hearing half the things I'm saying, don't even make me feel like that. Just, you know, nod your head, say, mm-hmm, yeah. Maybe ask a question or two and then let me go about my day. I just need a venting session real quick. And yeah, I feel like we really have to tell them, you know,
It's true. Like you, it's just temporary relief. That's it. Y'all know where I'm going with it at. Just don't be that guy. Don't be that guy that's gonna get me upset when I'm venting. So then I'm gonna feel like I can't vent to you no more.
Yeah.
And you're gonna be my man. No. It's not fair. I feel like that's setting the tone of your relationship alone. And it's even worse when you as the woman is listening more than the guy is. Okay, but I was listening to you. Why can't you listen to me? Or my way of approaching things are different than yours, but you could still tell me X, Y, Z. Like, I just don't. Y'all, you guys.
No, I understand. It can be so frustrating. It can be too much. Especially with the world that we live in now, we realize just how many things affect us and just how many things we don't speak about until it explodes. And it's like, you need people around you who don't make you feel like I'm just overthinking. I'm the one going like, you know, right. Am I the one exploding? Because personally for me, I have an issue with being overthinking, and I realize that it can affect me a lot if somebody in my corner is not a reassurance person. So if I'm the one overthinking,
I felt that in my soul. Like, yes, you know what's crazy? That I felt like I was constantly, I want to make sure I say this right way. If like, you want reassurance, but it's like the basics is what we're looking for. The basic reassurance that guys, people just won't remind you of. Personally, Tashika, y'all, she taught me how to say I love you, right? So I constantly say it, and it's just like, okay, but how many times a day do you need to hear that? You know? I'm like, if I don't say it, they're gonna be mad. Oh my God. So now I'm constantly saying, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. And it'd be small stuff. Like, the reassurance I'm looking for is like, do you still love me? Did I do something wrong? Like,
yes.
Are you mad at me? Did you eat today? Like, love language. I'm just throwing things out there to make sure that we're good. If things are out the norm, like we're not talking, you're gonna be like, are we okay? I'm just making sure, because we haven't spoken for the past 5 hours. Are we good? Everything fine. I'm just chilling. And I'll be like, oh, it was all so simple. Sometimes you're overthinking is not a bad thing. It really isn't. It's just how you deal with it. So now you got your answer. Now you got your answer that you're looking for. Now what? You're gonna calm down and stop being that person that overthinks? No. I'm still gonna overthink about you mad at me from earlier.
No, but I felt that. It's so like, you can think so much in a matter of 2 minutes. Like, even less than that, you can think so much. And sometimes I'm not even mad at people who think more than I do, where it's like, he's probably doing this right now, or he's probably doing that right now, because we've experienced that already. Like, you don't have to be in a relationship with somebody. It could be your parents, you know, those things will drive you insane. And for, you know, people to think it's not that deep, it's not that serious, but let me ask this question. How many friends do we have or had in our lives that said, no, everything's fine, and pretended like everything was okay until they exploded on you? And all of a sudden you should, because it's like, I've asked you so many times, are we good? And you wanted to fight me this whole time? Come on.
Hold up. I gotta add into that one. Yes, I'm gonna tell you why I feel like people do that. Cause I used to do the same thing. It's like, it just wasn't meant for me to say it. You'll know that I'm pissed at you, but for us to beef about it, you'll never know a thing sometimes. And it sucks. Again, it's not relevant no more. So then I just don't say anything. Yep, that's it.
Well, you're different, because say for instance, you don't really want to talk about it. I mean, yeah, you don't want to talk about it at that point in time. Hopefully nobody forces you to get to that point, because that's when you can explode. But there are people who will be so shady, who will, you know, hit you where it hurts, and you don't know. They will subtweet about you. They will go on live and be like, yo, this yada, yada, yada. And you be in the comment section like, who are you talking about? And they'd be like, I'm not talking about you. And then it's you the whole time. I'm just giving scenarios because I know that there are people out there who do it. Like, it's true. I've experienced a few. It might not have been that severe, but for people to just hold that against you when you are in the space to talk about it, you know, hurts. It's too much. It's too much. But on the next list, on the next point of the list, the third point is I would want someone to be spiritual or at least have a belief in something and not judge others on their belief.
Or even attempting to try to figure you out on your own belief.
Yes, because there are people who are out there who, you know, just don't believe in God. I'm not mad, because at the end of the day, everyone has a different path, different journey, a different belief. They could probably believe in a higher up, but it might not be God. It could be just, you know, meditation, what's out there, the beyond. I'm not going to judge anybody for that, because they can teach you so much. They can teach you how to meditate. They could teach you some music that they've listened to keep them calm. There are so many things out there that people don't understand, that it's not just your religion that can help you.
It's also, well, I can't answer that because I'm going to my next part. Never mind.
Well, yeah, like, you know, like I mentioned in my doc, if that centers with yourself and you find meditation, that's great for me. I'm not a full-on Seventh-day Adventist, but I do believe in God and I do pray, and I'm trying to create a stronger relationship with God, and I also meditate. So, you know, I have these different ways of trying to figure out myself and, you know, get in tune with my spirituality and my religion and have a focus. And I would just hope that someone else does the same thing. It doesn't have to be the exact same path. So
I'm going to jump into my next part because it goes into what you just said, and I'm going to piggyback off of it. My next part is being open-minded. You have to be compatible enough to understand that my beliefs on things are not yours and vice versa. Last year, you guys, I've gotten closer to God more than anything. And I have a habit now of telling people how to pray, or the things to do, things to say, what scripture to read, or they're feeling X, Y, Z. Like, that's just me now. And, you know, some people don't want to hear it. Now you have people that are into, hey, it's okay, I can try though, and maybe I'll hear what you're doing and I'll tell you, well, you should try this approach, and they'll probably be like, okay, and they'll probably just be like, no, I don't want to, I don't feel like it, I don't, no, everything is a no. I've had a situation where I was with this guy and I needed to go to therapy, or I wanted to go to therapy for the first time, and he wasn't even going to go with me. And he was just like, no, what do you need to go for? And I'm like, because I have issues. I'm trying to bring some humor into this, but I'm just like, because I want to go. And he just was like, no, I'm not going. He wasn't supportive. That's what I should have said. He just wasn't supportive. And I feel like, with me, I am very open to new things always. So if you're just with me and you don't even want to try to even look it up, if you had to, one little part of something can lead to the bigger parts of something else. And if you can't even take that first step for me, I can't do. Perfectly said. I dropped the mic.
Yes, that is something that I can say is a great thing to add on the list. On somebody that, you know, this is the person that I need in my corner. I want this person to be respectful of me in what I want to do in terms of my mind, because it's really your soul, your spirit, your mind, your body, everything is connected to each other. So I wish that person was like, you know, hey, if that's what you want to do, explain to me why. Like, I was remembering, I was talking to this guy, I was recently, and he wasn't necessarily opposed to therapy, but he was just genuine about why. Why therapy? Because people are saying I should go because I've been through so much, and I've processed it in a way that was concerning to them, because it's like things happen to me that I've just ate up like food, you know? And so they're just like, hey, you should probably, you know, go to therapy and really express yourself, because that can really cause some future damage to your mind, you know? So he was asking me, like, what about therapy? Like, I didn't know I needed it, so please tell me what are the pros and benefits and stuff. And you don't even have to go through something.
That's true. You really don't have to go through something. I do want to also say, and I think that was perfectly said, it's like, if you're gonna say no, at least tell me why. That's just it. If you can't back up why you just told me no, then I don't want to hear it. If I'm gonna tell you, baby, like, I want us to go to therapy, and you tell me no, I'm gonna just look at you and I'm gonna wait and say, why don't you want to go? You tell me something stupid like, I never been there before, so I don't want to go. And I'm gonna tell you, like, that's what you're going for, because I never been either. We both are going to this for the first time, and you're going to still tell me no, at least. And you're right, you don't have to go through something to go to therapy. I'm trying to put that through people's heads now, that you just want someone to talk to that's not going to judge you. That's why they're there. They don't choose a side, and there's more reasoning than you realize. And sometimes it just opens something in you that you never thought was there. That's just it. I think that was perfectly said. I feel like for the guys listening to this podcast, we are telling y'all, if you don't have a legit reason as to why we should not be doing something, bye. Bye.
Exactly. I could, like you said, it's perfectly said. If you can't explain why you, and that also ties in with your vulnerability. Tell me, I've been through so much. I processed it the way I could. I don't need therapy. And even if it sounds like it's defensive, okay.
I will respect that more than you to tell me no.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. No, but listen, questions are out there for a reason. And I feel like that's really what therapy for me is about. Sometimes the therapist asks you questions that you probably thought of or you haven't thought of. And they're not out there to, you know, judge you, but the questions may come as a judgment, you know, where you're asking yourself these questions like, man, I do that, don't I? And it makes you think. Therapy makes you think. And therapy puts you in a position to make your own choices and to think about your own thoughts and to have your own way of moving around in society, because society's hard to live in. It's so hard. So I'm not mad at someone reaching out, including myself, to a therapist on their own, right? Because, you know, people don't have to tell you to go. Just go and talk to somebody and say, hey, like, I've been, you know, really contemplating this business idea. I'm not too sure with all the things that are impacting my life. Your therapist asks you what's going on, you explain it to them, and it's, you can go for so many, that you don't have to be the idea of broken for, you know, people to be like, okay, like,
don't hesitate. That was perfectly, broken was the right word. Don't hesitate now. I feel like you don't even realize that you're broken. A lot of people just don't even know that they're broken. You could be walking around here like everything's all good, and baby, you're broken. But it takes that person, that professional person that you're supposed to be going to, possibly, but let me tell you, honey, you're broken. Now we gonna fix it. That's what I'm here for. I felt that. Snap, snap.
Yeah. Yes. And it's okay, because, you know, and that's where judgment comes in. We think that these people that are successful on YouTube and on Instagram and Twitter, walking up and down, the prettiest thing on the spot, you believe. And they're going through so much.
They're going through so much. And every therapist needs their own therapist.
Yes. Yes. Sometimes they don't be listening to their own stuff.
They don't, but that goes back to reassurance. They got to remember, like I told you the other day, that I don't remember my passions until I'm talking about it. Sometimes when you're just taking in everybody else's stuff so much, you don't even remember what you're doing. So I respect everybody that's in therapy, giving the therapist a hard time, quote unquote. And I respect the therapists that take the time to listen to us that are going through the basics of just something so basic, y'all. I'm talking about, I don't know, like, I just been feeling sad. I don't know why. And it'd be like the small things that you keep asking about that they have to deal with. But honestly, it's rewarding in the end. It's all rewarding to them and for yourself. It's rewarding for you to switch up your life. And it's rewarding for them to feel like they were the helping hand to you when no one else could have, somebody else could have done it. And nobody probably wasn't even doing it. And they took the time out to help you. So guys out here, you know, just know that it's okay. Like, your manlyhood is not gonna be taken away from you if you go to therapy. I feel like that's the most I'm gonna say sexiest, I don't care if you're listening, it's the most sexiest, respectful thing to do, to admit your own. The end. I'm done. Just admit, yes, what you, everything gonna be fine.
Own up. Like,
and that's actually moving on to my next part. If you don't mind, my next part of my list is let me handle my own. Let me tell y'all, I need a dude that gonna let me go out and be me and come home and be like, how was your day? And I'm gonna tell you all about my day. You're gonna be like, that's my girl, I'm proud, this is what I did. I don't want to feel like what I'm doing is, let me not say not for you, but it's just the fact that you let me go out there and tackle the world, and you don't judge me for it. You don't stop me from doing anything. You kind of, you support me to the fullest. You tell me what to do, how to do it. You even give me inputs on what I should be adding. And I'm actually dealing with that now, and I'm so grateful, because it's like, you're so caught up in somebody else's shadow, you know, and it's not fun. You lose sight of what you're doing, who you are, because you're with this person trying to make them proud, and they're doing their own thing, and you're not even realizing that you're stopping yourself. So that was emphasized on my list, you guys, that I need to go out and handle my own. As me personally, if you know me, like, I don't like asking, I don't like being a burden, I don't like feeling like I have to ask for permission to figure out if I'm being crazy or not for what I'm about to do. I'm my own person. I'm in a relationship, and I'm still going to be my own person, because I hate to say it this way, but with or without them, I'm still going to handle my own. It's simple. I'm done.
I love that, because you're speaking truth. From my experience, I posted lingerie pictures for Valentine's Day on my Instagram. And I was so scared before I posted them, because, you know, I felt like I had to seek some form of validation around me to make sure that it's not something that people would have an issue with. And I got scared with, you know, the idea of being in a relationship where somebody judges you for that. Like, oh, you know, this is mine and mine only, so I don't know why you posting it. If I'm right here, why couldn't you just send it to me? And it's like, people are out there who are doing that instead of just saying, yeah, that's my girl, and yeah, like, I'm his girl and only his girl, and he knows that, and he's telling everybody else that, even sharing your picture on his story. That, like, why?
You know what? I'm gonna comment. I'm gonna put some little truth in here. Okay. The truth is that it's a lot to it. Number one, if you have a baddie, like, let her be a baddie, right? I hope I don't offend nobody. I just can't, it's just my own insecurities. I cannot post them as much as I want to. Not because someone else told me, not because someone told me not to, and I don't have permission necessarily. It's just, I don't know, I have an insecurity about myself that I just won't share. But if you are dealing with somebody that is like bad as hell, and you come out with the energy of how you gonna post that, that should be for me only, it's gonna be for you only. It's okay. That makes you look it makes you look insecure. I don't want to say that to trigger nobody, but that's just what it is. You're mad insecure if you don't let your girl go handle her own.
It comes off as insecurity because it's like, why? You come home to it all the time. It's her expressing herself. So
it's expressing yourself. I feel like that's something I have to tell myself, that's what I'm doing. For someone that doesn't, y'all took my first lingerie photos kind of like 2 weeks ago. And that was amazing. It was really different. And I still haven't posted it on my main feeds because I don't know. I never thought I got this far. I don't want problems necessarily. I didn't want to. I don't want to speak like that. I didn't want to be. It's hard because I'm in a relationship now, but if I was single and I posted it, I didn't want to be judged for me posting those photos, whether it was you're bad compared to she degrading herself by posting this. And I just didn't want to be that target. And that's probably why I never got into posting stuff like that, because I didn't want to be looked at as that person. I'm always talking about carrying yourself in the right way, but what is really the right way? And I feel like you have insecure, yeah, right. You have insecure thoughts in your mind that this is what I'm going to do. This is how it's going to go. If you have a problem, like F it. I don't have that in me. And it's even better when your dude can tell you, go ahead and post this. Go ahead and show the world what I got. That is something that is so beautiful to me. I don't know why. So you posting those photos, like, if someone has something to say about it, like, F them. Because you did it for you. I get dressed for me. You got dressed for you. Ain't nobody checking for you. That's just what it is. So if y'all can't handle the pressure, like,
don't. Come out the kitchen. I'm out the kitchen. Because it's true, like, nowadays and even if it is about validation, we all are on social media posting, you know, tweeting for that interaction. So if I post what I post, I want there to be comments, I want there to be shares. For what? Why didn't I post it? I posted it for a reason, you know. And it's frustrating. It is.
I get like you. I'm trying to get like you, girl. I can.
Well, you can, though.
I can, y'all. I really can. It's just so freaking nerve-wracking. Because you don't know what's going to come your way. That's all.
That's true. But it's like, you know, when you do have to, you don't know how many people will also be able to do that solely because you did it. Mm-hmm. You know? So it would definitely be something where it's like, dang, if she can do it, so I can. And with all, like, if there ever comes with backlash, there are people who are always going to support you. And sometimes that could be even something that makes you larger than life. There's so many problems in this world that people are like, this person's been through so much. Why? And you can be the center of a conversation that should have been had a long time ago. So It could be that too. Who knows?
You guys, I'm gonna jump into the next part. I'm trying to make sense of everything kind of ties into one. Protector.
Wait, before we hop into that, I was looking at my list and I saw that something connected with what you said earlier about the attractiveness of a guy, not by his looks, but by what he says and how he reacts to things. And I added just recently the keeping, like, staying away from toxic masculinity and embracing your gender beyond masculinity.
Yes, that is so perfect.
Like, I've known a couple of friends who, a couple of guy friends who don't make that their soul, like, ew, like, things are fruit, like, I don't hear fruity anymore, like, dang, that's disgusting. Like, they be saying things that's just like, guys who consider themselves alpha males don't be saying that. You know what I mean? Like, guys who are so concerned about their gender don't be saying the things that my guy friends say, some of my guy friends say. And I find that to be so interesting that the world has evolved in such a way where you can say things and not be concerned. Like, yeah, I'm a, like, it's not gay to call your friends and want to hang out with them and say I love you and do all these things that people may find feminine, which is not. But, you know, I just enjoy, you know, Black boy love, Black boy joy, and seeing them express themselves in clothing that, you know, they may get judged by their own community with. And it's like, you're beautiful, and they accept that. You're a beautiful man, you're a very pretty man, you know what I mean? And they don't be like, whoa, that's kind of gay, don't you think? How's it gay? Like, those are like genuine comments. Like, how? Like, we're not in that state of mind anymore.
It's lack of it's lack of maturity, and it also goes back to being closed-minded. Like, you live in a time now where you just have to, you know what you gotta do. That's all I'm gonna say.
Hey, do what makes you feel good. That's kind of what it is. Black boy joy, do what makes you happy. Say things that make you expressive. Love yourself and be able to express how much you love yourself, how much you love your friends, both male and women. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's beautiful, truly. And just be who you want to be. Take pictures the way you want to take pictures. Show off your girlfriend. Express, talk about drama with her, you know, because she's into the gossip. And she's like, send her things that you know that she's into. If you're not into the shade room, but you see something that one of, you know, your friends send it to her. Like, yo, did you see this? And you're not interested at all. Like, that's okay, you know? So I guess it's just one of those things where it's like, be more expressive as a guy. Don't be held back by what your peers will say about you. For what?
Yes. Literally, if you're just constantly being that, y'all know the vibe I'm talking about. It's the vibes of like, nah, I'm not with it. It's just, no one is taking away your manhood. And I feel like that's just a big thing that a lot of people raise their kids to build up on, is to have this particular their particular way of being. And the way that they are before 18 is different how they are when they're over 18. Now they have a mind of their own when you're not there to teach them what to expect, what to accept, what is out of your reach, what is something that you don't mind thinking or talking about. And I just don't like, I don't like the lack of Black boy joy. I feel like that was perfectly said. I feel like the look of it as well, it's so freaking cool. Like, you saw the recent video of the guys on the boat listening to Fantasia?
Yes. Yes, it was so beautiful.
Like, they were really enjoying themselves with no judgment, and it's all guys on that boat, and I'm just like, go ahead, that's how it gotta be.
We love to see that. Like, I don't know if you remember this one video. And I'm laughing because it was such a cute and funny video of this girl. She does wigs, and her boyfriend put on one of her wigs, and it was on Twitter the whole time.
Yes, he was trying it on for her and everything. I like that.
Yes, and he was just like, period. He was really like flipping his hair in the mirror. So funny. And it's so cute because it's like, yeah, like, I have a girlfriend. this doesn't make me any less of a man.
Mm-hmm.
Why should it? I'm who I am, and that's just me. I just love it. I love just you expressing you as a person, as an identity, instead of saying, well, this is not what men do. You're mm-hmm. a man, aren't you? So do what makes you
like happy. Why are you questioning your, I don't know the word I'm looking for, but y'all know what I'm looking for.
Yeah, your masculinity, basically. And
you were taught, you were taught the right way. So in my, if in your opinion, if you feel like you were taught the right way, then why do you question it? Because somebody trying to so-called break you out of character, no, they just want you to loosen up.
Yeah.
Stop being so so stiff.
Yeah, stop being so traditional. Yes, that's the word. Traditional. Stop being traditional. Nobody wants to hear all of that. Like, nobody wants a suckish alpha male in their life. Okay. Nobody wants an alpha male, period. But we'll see about that. But what's your what's the thing that you mentioned earlier?
Protector. Trigger warning, I'm not gonna go into details, but I told Tashika, like, every guy I've had in my life have not protected me in any sort of way possible. So I am looking for someone that can either teach me how to protect myself, or is willing to protect me although I can handle myself, or just overall protecting me, period, when I really can't. Just being that guy that he's just down to just do whatever to make sure that you are safe. You got a knife? No, I don't got one. Okay, I'm gonna give you one. You got any pepper spray? No, I don't got one. I'm gonna give you one. You want a whole bundle of defense stuff? I got you. I'm here. I got you. But are you gonna pull up for me though? Are you gonna shoot out some people if you had to? Like, I need you to go ham for me as I would do for you. And that's just it. I don't want to feel like I'm constantly looking over my shoulders when we're walking together, feeling like somebody gonna rob us and you ain't gonna have my back. You gonna beat up somebody for me? Like, what is it? And a lot of dads taught their kids, children, how to fight back. Unfortunately, I wasn't one of those kids that fought back. I still don't feel like I really want to. Unfortunately, now we live in a society where I have to. I have to kind of be against my guards, what? Have my guards up to be prepared to fight. And if I am with you, what you gonna do? What are you about to do to make sure that I'm straight? Most importantly, trigger warning again. Matter of fact, I'm not gonna say that. I'm not gonna say that. I'm done. You can go.
I was talking to our friends about this, and I've seen it more and more on Twitter about how much a lot of us who are very dominant in our own lives mm-hmm. want somebody to be able to support us. Yes.
Be a leader.
Like, people are submissive by choice, some people, you know? And that's perfectly fine if that's what you want to be. Submissive.
Yeah. I think that was cool because I think I sent you something the other day about that. Right? About like the alpha male, and you just naturally submit to that person because they just come off as that leader. It's not even that you're, my name's Sienna and I'm going to do this and this is my plan. No, it's like you just come off in that way for me to submit to you. And I know the alpha male and the alpha male thing bothers people sometimes because now you're thinking that he got all power over you. No, that's not what I'm saying. It's the ability to lead when you can't. That's it. It's having the ability to lead while you can't, while you're the woman in charge, yes, but he is still, I ain't gonna curse. he's the head of, see, either way you kind of switch, it's like a double standard. It sucks
because it sounds dominant, like it sounds very aggressive, because people take advantage of that. There are guys who are the head of their household
with their,
right, the head of the household, who, you know, also treats his woman as his, you know, side by side, 50-50, where, yeah, she, you know, does different tasks than I do, but neither is less than the other. He doesn't feel like, yeah, I'm coming home, I did 40 hours a week, 40 plus a week, my job's tiring, and all you do is cook and clean, you know? But she has her schedule too, you know? She has things that are really hard and really tough that you wouldn't even imagine mentally, you know, handling, if that's what people do, handling two, like being support for two people.
Yeah.
A lot. It is a lot. So when people are in those roles, we're so hurt by them because people take advantage of them. But there are people out here who respect their woman so much that anything that is being said goes through her as well, instead of saying, I make the choices and I make the decisions in the house and you just go by them. He asks her first, and she's the to-go person. You talk to my wife first. Even though he might make more money than she does, you're go to her.
I have to ask my wife first. There's something about that that makes me like, okay, because it's like you're including me no matter.
Yes.
Although you feel like you are going to make the dominant decision, you're still including me in that decision. Yes.
Exactly. You that's what we want. Like, if that's something that you guys talk about, where, you know, he probably handles the majority of the bills while I handle the utilities or whatever it is, y'all need to have a discussion like that. But he cannot make you feel like, oh, all you do is take care of the kids, it ain't all that hard. Every single thing should be hard. And everybody should respect each other's responsibilities on what they do in the household. Come on now. If you see the dishes are dirty, clean them if you see them.
You live here too. Exactly. You got to make things comfortable for most of us. And you know what I was about to say was that, oh my God, I lose my train of thoughts. You made a good point. I can't remember it. I'm sad. Oh, I remember when I was dealing with this person, how they always made me feel so little. Literally, I'm little, y'all. But everything that they said was like, you got it. Okay, I'm sorry. My bad. I'm sorry. I'm constantly doing that because I put you in this position for me to submit to you. But it's like, it's so overbearing sometimes that I just make you do everything. Like, all decisions are all you. You make the decisions. You are in front of everything. You are saying yes or no. You're not even including me in anything. And that's where things ended up at on my end, unfortunately, to the point now I'm constantly still saying, I'm sorry. Or, are you sure about that? You good? Because X, Y, Z. It's not fair. It's not fair. That's a shame.
It's true.
I'm saying it's a shame because I allow myself to do that. Like, you're constantly, you're so used to the dominancy, is that, like, I'm dominant, but I'm highly scared to be assertive sometimes because I'm so used to submitting to a dude because he's my man. That's just natural.
Yeah, it's true, because sometimes we just, and it's honestly like, I feel really sorry because we've experienced so much for us to feel like we have to submit, that we have to submit, And everything should be a choice. Everything should be talked about amongst you guys. You know, if you guys break down the responsibilities amongst your relationship, that should be something that you guys do. And people take advantage of that so much. Like I mentioned earlier, so much, which is why when we think of submissive, when we think of a woman who is being submissive to the relationship, it don't really look good. It don't sound good because of what we've experienced. So it's pretty interesting. And honestly, my heart really goes out to our other peers who've experienced that, because it's so hard to find a person who isn't your past experience. Because it's so easy to find people that we've seen before, so toxic, so damaging to our lives, and we continue having that in different forms. And I can't be mad at people who end up in relationships with people who remind them of maybe a father or an uncle that's happened to. But it's just,
'cause you don't even look for those people. It's just installed in you that you find those people. You know, you end up dating someone like your father. It's an unconscious thing. It just happens. It just happens. You just met somebody that you was already used to.
Right. Yes. That you hit it on the nail. You find somebody that you're used to and you get comfortable and you're in the same pattern. You know, if you've known somebody who doesn't drive you, then you're going to be in the same pattern. You're going to feel weird when you find someone who does treat you right. And I think that's where we are with it.
Yeah.
It's so confusing. Like, I've battled so much with finding guys, and when they are on the same path that I am on, I'm just in my head figuring out, what exactly does this person mean? Like the Drewski video, like, what do you mean by that? It's like
the same level I was on.
And you're just like, I wonder if this person's gonna screw up. And you don't wish that on them at all.
It's just something that you're fearful of because of all you knew.
Yes.
What a damn shame. It's a shame that I'm saying it in the way that I am, because it's like, wow, when is that cycle gonna break? Like, you know, happiness came my way. Friendship, relationship, what, a few years ago, like 4-3 years ago. And I was just like, this is weird. Is this really happening? Oh my god, you know. And I'm just like, okay, I don't like this so much, because you too nice, you too cute, you too sweet. Is this really supposed to happen right now? And it's really sad, because it's like, now you got that person, you're driving away that person because of something that you lacked. What a damn shame.
It's true. And to add on to, you know, just all the cutesy qualities that we want, and just how it's like, wow, you're just so, I still have my little list with my dude being tall, and I want him to be funny, and I want him to be able to dress. Like, I have my little elementary school list.
It is not elementary school. I feel like it is. I know that I should have done this, but I was supposed to separate my list from surface level stuff to internal stuff. And the surface level is what we, you know, quick to say what it is, but just like tonight when I was talking about myself on my Instagram, you don't think about the things that you really need to figure out. I have a habit of not knowing what I don't like until I don't like it. I can't tell you what I don't like. So with my list, it's like, yeah, I need him to be tall, and he can dress, and he can compliment my style, and we can be bomb together. Woo! Your hygiene's gotta be up there, okay? Your hair gotta be done. You need a beard that connects, okay? Your beard needs to connect, y'all. What's your mind like, though? Are you open to therapy? Would you go to therapy with me? Are you a good listener? Can you money? Do you know how to count? Can you fix a tire? Listen, I have a lot of stuff on here because are you willing to lift me up when I'm down? If y'all haven't heard 21 questions, I advise you to listen to it again. Because those questions were legit though. Are you gonna be that person I can count on to support me mentally? Damn it, are you gonna give me your laughs? You know what I'm saying? Love language, I'm also learning that. Your love language. Let's talk about that real quick. Your love languages. During this whole time, we've been on lockdown since last year of February. Dang, that's true. Since February, I have learned more about myself than I've ever thought. I have learned that I don't like to go out as often as I used to. I have learned that I'm a more physical lover. But now this quarantine has taught me to love in a different way. And some guys just go with the flow. They don't really know their love language until you ask. What's that? And then your love languages, I think they divide into 5 different things, if I'm not mistaken. I don't necessarily know all of them. I just know like physical touch is one. And
words of affirmation.
Words of affirmation. Ah, that's so me. That is so me.
Gifts.
There. What else are you gonna do? You know what I'm saying? You have to find other ways to love somebody and being inspired. I say this so often lately, but it's just something that's real. Being inspired to wanting to love me is something I just love. If you just out here thinking that I'm supposed to know that you care or that you love me because you told me this month ago, no. So the reassurance definitely comes into play when it comes to that. And I feel like you know what's really crazy? I'm reading this list and I realized that I kind of put everything twice in different words. Like the confidence in the man, the confidence in your walk, the confidence in wanting to show me off, the confidence of loving me, period. Just even if you don't know how to love, the thought that you feel confident enough to doing it the way that you know how, what opened me up into loving you the way that I know how, we'll be okay. If that makes sense. I feel like having your head down, both of us can't do that. We both can't be, I don't know. No. Like, no, I feel like that goes back to the whole alpha male thing. And that's why it's all hard. It's really hard. One of us got to be up. Both of us can be up. I'm not saying that one of us are going to be down always. It's not the case. But while I'm down, how are you going to pick me up? And vice versa. And if you feel like you didn't do a good job, you got to fix that. A lot of times that, even now, I'm not down to the fullest, but I was down. And luckily, I have somebody that can lift me. And our conversations go like, and it's always a joke, you guys, but it's always like, I can't wait for me to be down, for what are you gonna do? And I'm kind of excited to show him that I'm not gonna keep you down the whole time. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna have you out here with your head down when I'm not gonna feel confident in what I'm doing. I'm gonna feel like I'm not doing a good job. You're not telling me nothing. You're just out here feeling more worse than you did when you stepped in the storm. No. I need to be there for you, period. And having confidence as a man is, I'm not saying that men lack it so much, but they teach you a small part of it. They teach you, I can go get that girl and that girl and that girl. Like, no. If I ask you a question, you should be able to answer it with so much confidence. It's just the mannerism, the demeanor in your body language, the the way you come off, you can just tell. And that goes back to submitting to your dude naturally. And I feel like all that just come into play in the best way possible. And I don't want to be repetitive, but that's just what it is. Yeah, that was perfectly said.
Yes, it was. Because, hey, like, sometimes you need that support system. Well, not sometimes, but all the time. We need a support system. We need some brace to support us and to help us when we're down. And when we're both down, it's like, okay, so who's gonna get up first? Like, we can't be both down for too long anyway. Like, we can have a little pity party for a minute, but we really gotta figure out how we're gonna work. And I think that's really a huge thing, because like, there are some examples of guys who, when they're down, like if they don't have a job, they will explode on anybody, you know? And it's like, if you're not really having some form of positive mindset to say, okay, let's figure out the next step, let's figure out our goals, let's reinforce certain things, let's not get ourselves too deep into a hole, because once you jump in that hole, it's really hard to get out. So it's like, you know, let's have a more positive way of looking at things.
It's all about how you come out. You don't ever... what am I saying? You always come out a different person than you... you always come out a different person than you was before you walked in the storm. That's just it. And when... wow, she took all the words out of my mouth. I'm kind of sad now. Because that was just perfectly sad. It's like, yeah, I don't got it. I don't got anything. You said it perfectly. We both can't be down here trying to figure out what if. Now, don't get me wrong. I have moments where I do come off really negative. Like, this ain't going to work. I don't want no parts of it. Nope, 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 nope. But some, you got to be like, baby, it's okay, you know, it's gonna work out. But you gotta do more than that. You gotta kind of be the lead, be the example. That goes back to saying, if you can do it, I can do it too. But if you're not motivating, it does not help nobody. Like, I will sit here with you. I will be stubborn. I will sit here with you. You wanna sit? Okay, bet. Let's get comfortable here. We ain't getting up at all. I'm petty and I'm that person. But now that I'm older, I realize like, you can't be like that forever. So as I just said, you can't, I can't get comfortable with you. And that's why people are quick to let people go, because you're not pushing me to wanting to be a better woman for you. And I'm not pushing you to be a better man for me and yourself. You got to meet people that can make you be higher than what you feel like you are. And yeah, that's just perfect. That was it.
Yes, let me tell you, I agree wholeheartedly. We can't both be super duper negative. Sometimes you have to have people where it's like, oh, he's so annoying or she's so irritating. Mm-hmm. But you apologize to them later when you know, said, I'm sorry that I was being negative, but I'm very grateful for what you said to me earlier. I listened, I heard what you said. It's a really good idea. And I'm gonna do it the next time around.
And that's crazy that you said that, because I need a dude that is able to apologize. You cannot be out here like, that's how she feels, so that's just it. No, I feel like you have to know when to say, I'm sorry, to be accountable, held accountable for your parts of things, and vice versa. But when both of you guys are petty and both of y'all are like, you just don't care, you know, I don't like that. And if you have been there, like, you understand what I'm talking about. It's just not it. It's not it. And that's why people go outside, unfortunately. They step out. That's where cheating comes from. I now understand. Disclaimer, I don't like doing it. It's not worth it. If you are with somebody that's not helping you grow, then let it go.
If they're not meant for you, leave. life. Don't be waiting years and years. And you guys have been together for 15, 20 years and y'all looking at each other like, so, and unhappy, right? But yeah, so that's just our little list. As we grow older, we're always gonna add new things to it, you know, upgrade, say, hey, this is who I found in my world. I manifested it and this is the guy for me. We're gonna try our best not to feel like we don't deserve the greatest things in the world. And if you guys have a list, secretly, because not everyone's gonna tell you if they have a list or not, we're just the public ones. But if you do have a list, you know, and you believe in prayer, pray and manifest, meditate it, manifest that guy, manifest that girl, like,
get. And I just want to add one more thing, just, and this is not to create controversial conversations, and if it does, I'm sorry. I think not really. Just a reminder that manifestation and prayer are two different things, okay? And she's right. If you have a list of requirements, let it be. You're not crazy. Honestly, we were watching Girlfriends and that's how this all came about. Like, you know, they had a list and they were telling Joan that she was being picky. And I'm like, you know what? No, she's not. No, she's not. She just wants this to happen at a certain time and it just wasn't working out for her. It's never a bad thing to want things for yourself. It's never a bad thing to have a personal list, whether it's stupid stuff or major stuff, surface levels or internal. And as Toshika says, just pray on the things that you want. And for those that wait, good things always come to you.
Yeah, so a little reminder every day to add on the other reminders that you guys have. Please know that you guys deserve nothing but the best. If new people come into your life or old people that they want to create a stronger bond with you and they're just perfect and a little too perfect, you believe, please don't try to figure out what's wrong with them, because you might find something that wasn't there in the first place and you created it on yourself.
Wow, that's how you end this podcast. That was perfectly said.
But just enjoy the moment. Enjoy him FaceTiming you if you want. Enjoying that everyday text, that good morning text, baby. The messages, and just enjoying him and her with, you know, whatever it is, whatever you enjoy about them. Keep on enjoying it and expand on that. Yes. So if you guys have reached to the end of this podcast, thank you so much for listening. Please share with your family and your friends. I love you guys so much. Thank you, C, for being on this episode.
You're welcome.
And she will be on more, hopefully more to come. But yeah, we're expanding, guys. We're expanding our network. We're excited.
I'm excited.
So thank you all again, and comment how you guys feel about this episode, and we'll be happy to hear from you. So bye, guys.